Chị Lê Trần xin được trở lại với chương trình Kiến thức y khoa gia đình và xã hội, và một lần nữa với sự góp mặt của cha Christopher Tuấn Phạm, là cha phó của nhà thờ Chánh Tòa Chúa Kitô, phải không ạ?
Yes, đúng rồi, cảm ơn chị.
Mình cũng biết nôm na là nhà thờ kính.
Yeah.
Và bên cạnh đó là Dr. Elizabeth Nguyễn, là Project Manager cho Linh Đài Đức Mẹ La Vang tại nhà thờ Chánh Tòa. Julie cũng như là cha Chris và bác sĩ Elizabeth xin phép với quý vị là cho chúng tôi dùng anh Văn để mà chuyển những cái chia sẻ này đến các em của thế hệ nối tiếp. So what is going on with the project? What is the newest new that you can share with our younger viewers about the Đức Mẹ La Vang Shrine?
Okay, thank you, chị Julie. First of all, I say hi to all the viewers and also our Tuny around the world, especially in Diocese of Orange. And we are going to celebrate and honor on the behalf of Bishop Bishop Kevin Van. Mm. So we are going to bless the site at the Christ Cathedral for Our Lady La Plavin. Mm. And also we call a Marian Court on October 21st.
So it's 4 days from today.
Yes.
It's going to happen on the Saturday, the 31st, phải không ạ?
The 21st.
The 21st.
So Saturday, starting at 3:30. What we'll do is we'll meet in the Arboretum, which is the where we have Mass now at the cathedral, and there'll be a Marian procession joined by various ministries in the diocese, and then we will process to the shrine site where she will be built, where the La Vang site will be built, and then we will have Mass celebrated by, of course, our most beloved Reverend Bishop Van, and co-celebrated by two more bishops, Bishop Maithan Leung and also Bishop Fryer, and of course Father Christopher and many priests in the diocese. This is a very special event for us, and to add on to what Father Christopher said earlier, the good news is that very recently, on September 8th, we officially had our design approved. So we had the proof of the project, but then the project...
That's the hardest thing. That's the hardest thing in any planning project.
Yes. So the bishop and the committee, his committee, unanimously approved our design with no changes. That means the area that they set out to give to us to build the shrine, the way we've designed it to match all the different architecture pieces of the cathedral, they're happy. They think it's beautiful. They think it's a nice addition to the existing campus. They're very happy, and this is the most wonderful news that our committee and the priests community has been internally celebrating, and we're very happy today to share that with our viewers.
It's so excited to have finally the Shrine of Đức Mẹ La Vang in our own backyard.
Yes.
So in the future,
we have been waiting for so many years.
I know. So later on, we can have the Đại hội Thánh Mẫu.
Yes.
In California, instead of we had to drive all the way down to Missouri, that's where originally the Marian days.
Yeah, sometimes we have to go to Las Vegas too.
Yeah. That's true.
Sometimes.
So when I was a child, I used to go with my parents to Marian days in Missouri. And although it's very holy, it's very beautiful, but it's a long way. So this is going to be something as an option for those that we want to do something in California. We're so close to Disneyland, so go to Little Saigon, Little Saigon TV. So I think it's, you know, it's a nice option for people, and definitely there's a lot of people that can't travel that far anymore.
So how this project affected to the youth, youth Eucharistic, or even youth sinh viên công giáo, thiếu nhi thánh thể, or the youth group in you know, everywhere in California and other states that they can come? What is their role that they might contribute to the project?
Thank you for asking. From my understanding, on 21st, I mean, we have our processions, the Tuny will dress up like uniform, you know, whatever parish you belong to. So all we join together, processions, you know, that are signified for the Tuny, or even you can come, whatever, even you not belong to any groups, you can come and join with us. Little free. There's no free that, you know, we don't charge anything. We have a chair for you. We have the big site of over four
acres. That's what
we got 3,000 chairs and standing room.
Wow.
Yeah. How many acres do we have for the site?
The site is 4 acres. So off of the corner of Chapman and Lewis, actually this is prime real estate. Even if any person have all the money in the world, they cannot purchase this. This is actually an honor for us to be able to build an emblem of the Vietnamese heritage right on the cathedral campus. And to add to what Father Christopher is trying to say is that, you know, we started out the project as a building honoring Đức Mẹ La Vang, but it's definitely for everybody. Mary is Mary.
Right.
She just happens to be wearing aozai, right? So I think the future, what your question is, what's the role of the young people, right? First of all, there's going to be một cái linh tượng, right? It's a statue of her. Mm-hmm. And then you have a Marian garden, cái vườn thánh mẫu. So that is the future of where the ministries can come and pray and reflect. You can have outdoors wedding, hopefully, Father.
Yeah. Right?
And then
I can imagine that.
We also have the four stations for the, you know, represent for four mysteries.
Oh, yeah. Wow. So, life events.
Tức là so it's bốn like chặng đàng của.
I'm gonna be missing this event because I will be in safari.
Oh,
yeah.
But we are streaming live. So the diocese has committed to stream live, and then we just need to connect the various channels. And this is an important point I want to make. Mm-hmm. We, you know, have been working in parallel with the diocese. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. This is a very big project, not in terms of finance, in terms of importance, but also in terms of relationship.
Wow.
I think this is the first big project that the Vietnamese community, Catholic community, is jointly working side by side with diocese management. Mm-hmm. And we have the support on this particular event, the Blessing Day, to stream live from the diocese media, of course in conjunction with Vietnamese media channels. And this is something that is almost unheard of, because usually we do our own event and then they do our own. So yes, it will be streaming live. And going back to the youth ministry, we hope that as we go through this journey, we'll get more people involved, more younger people. We always need good ideas and volunteers. And then definitely the true benefits will belong to the new generation.
Yes, yes.
She's gonna stand there forever.
Right. And the younger generation need to be more involved.
Yes.
With the church activity, church projects, due to the reason that even as our generation, we're gonna be died down. I mean, we're gonna step back and let the next generation take over and continue on with the journey that we leave behind for them. Mm-hmm. Now, as far as the parishioner everywhere, as far as guests, regardless what religious that they are attending to this event, kính thưa quý vị, đây là một cái buổi lễ mà đối với cá nhân Julie là người Công giáo, Julie cảm thấy rất là quan trọng, nhưng mà rất tiếc là cái thời điểm đó Julie không có nhà cho nên sẽ không có thể tham dự được. Though I cannot attend to the event, but due to the live stream, I can watch it, and I can at the same time pray with everyone.
Yes.
However, we're gonna take a short break, and when we come back, I would like to share for you both to share with the audience, our viewers, what can they do as a parishioner, as attendees, to help this project to be successful. Xin quý vị tiếp tục theo dõi. Chúng ta sẽ trở lại sau phần quảng cáo ngắn.